faculty you have, the power of thinking or of moving your limbs from moment to moment, is given you by God if you devoted every moment of your whole life exclusively to his service. You could not give him anything that was not, in a sense, his own already. And since we're talking about stewardship today, I thought it was appropriate to take from C.S. Lewis. And then also I thought it was appropriate to go and do a little bit of research and a little bit of reading. Well, I found, pardon me, I've got four broken ribs, so when I try to breathe, it's like, I'm not nervous, it's just I can't breathe. Okay. So I went over and I looked at Bill Peel, and he said he's got a website, a blog called The High Calling, and he usually is pretty clever and pretty smart on a lot of different items and different topics. And recently he wrote a really, really, really good essay, and it's entitled Leadership is Stewardship. And I thought it was original, and I thought it was pertinent. And I'd like to share with you today, right now, some of his thoughts, and then some of mine. And in his essay, Peel suggests that there are four really important principles about biblical stewardship that we must understand. And here they are. The first one is the principle of ownership. The psalmist begins the 24th Psalm with, "The earth is the Lord's, and everything in it, the world and all who live on it." In the beginning of Genesis, God creates everything, and he puts Adam in the garden to work on it and to take care of it. It's really clear that man was created to work, and that work is stewardship of all the creation that God has given him. Peel's contention is that this is the fundamental principle of biblical stewardship. God owns everything. We are simply the managers or the administrators acting on his behalf. So, then, stewardship expresses our obedience regarding the administration of everything that God has placed under our control, which is all-encompassing. Stewardship is the commitment of oneself and one's possession to God's service, recognizing that we do not have the right to control over our property or ourselves. The second principle of biblical stewardship is the principle of responsibility, says Peel. In explaining, he says, quote, "Although God gives us all things richly to enjoy, nothing is ours. Nothing really belongs to us. God owns everything. We are responsible for how we treat it and what we do with it. While we complain about our rights here on earth, the Bible consistently asks us, what about our responsibilities?" And this is what I think is really good. Owners have rights. Stewards have responsibilities. End quote. We are called as God's stewards to manage that which belongs to God. While God has graciously entrusted us with the care, with the development, and with the enjoyment of everything he owns as his stewards, we are responsible to manage his holdings well in accordance with his desires and his purposes. It is, after all, of thine own have we given it. Have we given thee, Jesus God. I still remember we did this several years ago, and it was wonderful. The third principle is the principle of accountability. Peel says a steward is one who manages the possessions of another. We are all stewards of the resources, abilities, and opportunities that God has entrusted to our care. Like the servants in the parable of the talents, we will be called to give an account of how we have administered everything that we have been given, including our time, money, abilities, information, wisdom, relationships, and authority. We will all have to give account to the rightful owner as to how well we manage the things to which we have been entrusted. And the fourth principle is that principle of reward. We should all long to hear our Lord say what he explains in Matthew 25:21. "Well done, my good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come
and share your master's happiness. And perhaps that principle of reward to me is the most profound. But what it says to me is that as Christians in the 21st century, perhaps we ought to think about embracing this larger biblical view of stewardship, one which goes beyond tithing and budgeting. Although these things are important, perhaps we need to be faithful stewards of all God has given us, all the opportunities presented through his providence to glorify him, ever mindful to always try to serve the common good, because it's what connects everything we do to what God is doing in the world. Thank you.
His special lady with the bishop's Daughters of the King class.